In this video, I'm going to show you guys the hashtag 1 best deck to play for Challenger 1 in Clash Royale. And it is this deck right here. So, P.E.K.K.A. Skeleton Battle Black Prince deck. So this is a really simple deck to use because, of course, this deck have a lot of swarms and spam stuff. So, all you need to do is to find the perfect opportunity to spam your stuff. And you should win. That is how simple this deck is. So anyways, let's show you how to use this easy deck in Clash Royale. So first, in Challenger 1, you will most likely face against enemies which have high level cards, like level 14 or level 13. And because of that, you need as much firepower as possible to destroy those high level cards. So bringing tank killers like P.E.K.K.A., Bats, and Skeleton Army are really important. So also, people in these trophies are kinda dumb. So usually, you cannot beat them with the levels, but you can beat them with skill. Because of course, remember, these players right here, even though they have high levels, they are really dumb. So you can eventually just beat them with your skill. And because of that, it's really important to bring a really high skill deck so that you can outplay your enemy, especially on Challenger 1, where most people are absolutely stupid. Now let's go Dark Prince right here. Boom. That's you to the mini P.E.K.K.A. Yep. The Dark Prince is just so much good because it have a shield which allow it to soak up a lot of damage from enemy troops. So that is why Dark Prince is one of the best card for low trophies or basically low level cards, because Dark Prince have a shield which allow it to soak up any damage. Doesn't matter if it's Sparky or as tiny as Skeleton, the Dark Prince will always soak up and take the same damage with the shield. That's why the Dark Prince is one of the best card for low level in Clash Royale, because doesn't matter if the Dark Prince shield got shot by the level 14 Sparky, it will always be the same. So yeah, Dark Prince is one of the best low level cards. Now, the same thing can also be applied with the Skeleton Army, because doesn't matter what the level is, it will always be died to a Lock or Mini P.E.K.K.A. Okay, so to be honest, I'm wasting the Dark Prince right there because it's kinda unnecessary. The Mini P.E.K.K.A. will eventually die anyway, so there's a waste right there. Now he will go Mega Knight. I can do a P.E.K.K.A. right here. This will help me prepare a good defense. Now, Skeleton Battle is one of those cards which is kinda good, but people just don't use it because remember, Skeleton Battle can deal a lot of damage. If it is not answered, it can literally take out 50% of your enemy HP. I'm not even joking. Okay, now that mini battle could bring some big trouble though, so I need to go that. Boom. As you can see, this deck is crazy good. Just need to keep up the spam. If you can keep up the spam and spam properly in the correct time, you should have a really good success with this deck. Just spam on the perfect time with the perfect timing and the perfect placement, and you should be good to go. So yeah, you want to try to first prioritize defense, and P.E.K.K.A. is one of the best cards for destroying high level cards. This P.E.K.K.A. right here can destroy a max level Mega Knight. This can also destroy a Golem and maybe an Electro Giant and Prince. That's why P.E.K.K.A. is one of the best cards for low level, because it can destroy anything. Even with low level P.E.K.K.A., it can serve its purpose. That's why. Now, let's think right here for a second. Now I want him to play first, because okay, so he want to go up P.E.K.K.A. on the bridge, come down. Never do that. That is absolutely stupid. No, I'm going to go Skeleton right here. The Skeleton will hopefully distract the P.E.K.K.A. Wow, look at that, guys. That is a perfect defense. Skeleton Army absolutely doing work. It is literally the hands down best card for low level Skeleton Army. It is so good. Now, yep, he will also have Skeleton Army, so I zap that. Then I can go Skeleton Battle right here. Look at the P.E.K.K.A. guys. Absolutely destroy his power. So now, even if you go Mega Knight, the Mega Knight won't be enough for that. Nope. Okay. Now the Skeleton Battle deal a lot of damage, as well as the P.E.K.K.A. Now I can go Dark Prince right here. The Dark Prince will just destroy that Mega Knight. Now the reason that I'm putting the Dark Prince right here is so that the Mega Knight will jump. So it will be on range on my second tower as well, so that this tower right here can help on defense to quickly and kill the Meganet more faster. So in the case of a Dark Prince, I can put the Dark Prince right here because it has a shield. Doesn't matter if the Meganet jump or not, it will do the same damage. So why not just put it right here? Because the other tower can help. If I put it on the knee right here, the other tower cannot help. So it will be much better for me to do this right here. But if it's like a Valkyrie, you need to put the Valkyrie right here. Because if you put it right here, the Meganet will do way more damage to the Valkyrie. So yeah, that is one of the advantage of Dark Prince. The shield is really handy, especially for defense like a big pushes like Sparky, Meganets, and Pekkas. Yeah, now let's go Best right here. The Best will quickly kill the Electro Wizard. Let's go. Best are seriously strong. Don't ignore that. Now I will go Electro Wizard. Then let's see what he will do. Okay, what the freak, what the freak, what the freak. Calm down, you're so dumb. Now I will go. Okay, so he will go lock. I can go Skeleton Battle. Boom. Now what the freak, you little shot. Calm down. Don't play so goddamn aggressive. Now I will go Electro Wizard for that. Boom. Electro Wizard will do a lot of job. And look at that. The Skeleton Battle and the Dark Prince also do a lot of work. Now I will zap the Skeleton so that the Electro Wizard can live. Now I will also go Skeleton Battle right here, and the Electro Wizard will finish everything off. Yeah, so as you can see on the last two matches, both of our enemies are really stupid. So yeah, that's the thing with Challenger 1. People have really high level cards, but they simply don't have the skill. Just outplay the meter skill and you should be good to go. Skill is number one, it's the most important thing. So anyways, let's go to our last match of the video right here against a level 11. So hopefully this will be challenging because our last two enemies are basically too easy. Yep, you heard it right, it's too easy. Now I will go Pekka. Boom. Okay, that will get one hit. Whatever, who cares, right? Now, ooh, Archer. Maybe he is a pro player. No, usually people in Challenger 1 never use Skeleton Archer because it seems like a bad card. But if you see people see it, you know that is probably a pro player, or maybe like someone who has better skill than the average Challenger 1 player. Now I will go Skeleton Battle right here. Best for the battle. Boom. So the struggle is still there because our enemy have high level cards. Meanwhile, I only have level 10 backs and level 10 tower. So you can feel the struggle right there. The card level is so painful. Now, oh, what the freak. You're so aggressive. Calm down. This is illegal. Now he will go Hawk. Okay, no Hawk Rider. Suspect, suspect, sasibaka. Now, Archer. What? Why? Wait, what the freak? Archer survive. Don't expect that. Now I will go Pekka right here. He will go Hawk Rider somewhere. Wait, what's our Hawk Rider? I know he wanna do it, don't lie. Now I will go Dark Prince right here. Boom. Then I need to prepare my zap because he will go something called the Skeleton Army. Just kidding. Wow, there's a waste of elixir. Wow, okay, he don't do the Skeleton Army. There's a complete piece of elixir. Now I will go Electro Wizard right here though. Okay, Best will actually do some work on defense. That's good. Now Electro Wizard will also do some work on offense. Meh. I don't care. Not too bad, I suppose. Now I will go Skeleton Army right here because he will go lock. Yep, okay, no lock, whatever. Now he will go lock right here. Okay, I need to fireball the princess. Then he will go Hawk Rider. I can go Pekka right here. Yep, it is so obvious. You will go Hawk Rider. Nope, that lock won't save you, son. You're a little shot. Now I will go Skeleton Battle right here for blocking the Inferno Tower. I can go Dark Prince as well. Then I can go some bats. I can zap away the Skeleton Army. Now look at that crap. That crap's absolutely got destroyed. Now I will go Skeleton Battle too. Boom. Wow, so as you can see, even against player with high level cards, we can still win really easily. It is a matter of skill. It's simple. If you can outplay your enemy, it's simple and easy. Now I will go Dark Prince right here so that the skeleton won't take my tower, and hopefully with 2 seconds left our enemy will not take our tower and we will survive. So yeah, it's simple and also really effective. So this is the best deck for Challenger 1. Hopefully this deck will be useful, and thanks for watching. Bye.